What's up guys, Nick here, and today I want to talk about video codecs and kind of the limitations of shooting on a DSLR like this in something like Canon's IPB codec. So first things first, what is a codec? Basically, it's how your video gets encoded and saved to your memory card. For example, this is IPB codec. High-end cinema cameras shoot RAW or ProRes, which is a lot more of a beefy codec. Now when I say beefy codec, I am referring to the megabits per second that are captured in a video. For example, Canon's IPB at 1080p 24 frames a second is around 30 megabits. Bits a second, but if you move up to, let's say, Canon's All-I codec, which is on their higher end cameras like the EOS R, in 4K that shoots at 480 megabits per second. So it has a lot more information there to work with. So when you're color grading in post, you can manipulate that footage a lot more. And one of the factors that play into making cinema cameras seem so much more high quality is the actual color depth they capture. For example, this camera here captures an 8-bit color depth, which means it captures around 16 million different colors, which sounds like a lot, and to be honest, it is. When you start looking at 10-bit, that's over a billion colors, and 12-bit is around 68 billion colors. So that's why cinema cameras are, one, so expensive because they're capturing so many different colors, and two, they have that nice natural cinematic look because they're seeing just as much, if not more, colors than the human eye can see. And when you're capturing so many colors, when you go to edit and color grade in the post-production, that means there's a lot more colors there to actually go through and correct in post-production. So I've owned this camera for a little over a year, and ever since the day I got it in the mail, I installed Technicolor CineStyle on it. Now, as most of you know, it is a flat picture profile designed to work with Canon EOS cameras. I've gone from shooting everything in CineStyle to now I shoot about 80% of it just in the standard color profile. Now, the reason I started doing that is because this codec is so light. I noticed a few weeks ago in the video where I was talking about creating an atmosphere in your films, that when I went in there to really get into the color grade and change colors and manipulate them, that this codec just simply does not have enough information to support that type of color grading. You might have noticed it in the shadows in the shot. They tend to get grainy when there's not enough information there and you're really pushing it too hard. And I've noticed that quite a bit, so that's why I've been shooting a lot more in the standard profile. Also, because when I'm vlogging, I'm changing environments. Lighting is changing, the white balance is changing. And if I was shooting in log, I have to keep adjusting the color grading stuff like that. But in the standard picture profile, it does all of that for me. So shooting standard makes the footage look a little bit better because there's not as much noise in it because I don't have to push the color grade. And it also saves time in post-production without having to do much color correction because Canon's colors right out of camera look so good. But I still shoot in CineStyle for when I'm in my set environment for my camera setting up here and I have the nice lens on it, doing a nice tutorial in my room, because there I don't really have to do much color grading. I just gotta add in some contrast, add in some saturation, and it looks really good with minimal work. You might be asking, why would you even shoot log in the first place? Now, it's always been said that shooting in log retains more dynamic range, and I have noticed that to be true. And that's why I still like to shoot log simply in my set environment, because I notice that the shadows on my face, I can change how harsh they are in the post-production, and it still looks relatively good because I'm not actually going in there and physically manipulating individual colors like I was. And it does help retain a little bit of that dynamic range, giving more of a cinematic look, but for the majority of shooting I do, like these vlogs, going outside, things like that, it doesn't make much sense to shoot in CineStyle. But I still have it because, one, it's already installed, and two, I like the colors that come out of CineStyle when I'm filming a tutorial. But that's pretty much it for me, guys. Thank you all for watching. Make sure to like and subscribe if you are new. I will see you guys in the next video. Peace out.